Imagine a device with 100 trillion circuitry connections, all communicating simultaneously in all directions. Inputs are based on experiences and observations. Now, this device has deliverables that are based on instincts, intuitions, hunches, and feelings. What would the input device be? It's your hand. You've been using this device your entire life. It's your brain. It's the brain that processes the immensity of a cathedral and perceives art, beauty, and form. Is the same brain that controls body outputs. This muscle memory on your body and on your brain and your body are linked. Brain, eye, hand. The simplest of hand movements creates a minimized structural member as less ink or graphite on paper, which means less steel in the air. So why is the design, the hand sketching process, a vital part of the overall design process? Well, prior to the advent of digital drawing tools, everything was done by hand. Detailed drawings and calculations needed to be performed, along with isometric drawings showing how components interacted. One actually had to develop and communicate your ideas. Some examples: Leonardo da Vinci, perhaps one of the greatest designers, sketchers, and inventors of all time. Frank Gehry, his projects all begin with simple hand sketches, and they are digitally designed. The 747, the Space Shuttle, the St. Louis Arch, and my favorite, the Eads Bridge. Now, I use various 3D modeling programs to design and to facilitate the fabrication and installation of custom facades. There is no question that the use of these programs and the complex geometries involved are simplified by use of these. However, at some point, someone began the entire process with a simple hand sketch. At its core, sketching is about communication. It is an interactive conversation, a conversation between your brain, your eye, and your hand. I truly believe there is a connection that is made that cannot be synthetic. It is special, and it is highly dependent upon feedback. Sketching is also the most effective way to communicate your ideas to another team member. If you can't quickly communicate these thoughts, then you're in trouble. How are you going to tell somebody what you want to do? Sometimes words alone just won't cut it. Recently, I was in a meeting in Miami to discuss a series of pedestrian bridges that are going to be built along an old railroad right-of-way to convert it into a trail. We had a digital model to review, but we chose not to use it. We used a whiteboard instead in order to communicate and kind of sketch through our ideas. So this is after about 40 minutes of sketching. These are just a bunch of scribbles. There's nonsense on the whiteboard, right? Not really. These simple sketches, now shown on a whiteboard, depicted a structural solution set and a path forward. More importantly, we each understood, clearly understood, exactly what our ideas and how we were going to go forward. Sometimes it only takes a few lines on paper, or on a whiteboard in this case, in order to solidify your ideas. As a matter of fact, I can't remember a single design meeting where I did not use a hand sketch. Sketching is visual thinking that enhances your ability to come up with solutions. It is an extremely fast process that allows you to explore numerous possibilities. Sketching is also incredibly scary. Many do not like it because they are afraid and or because they don't want to be criticized about their lack of doing it. The more you do it, the better you become and the more effective it is. Your sketches, they don't need to be perfect. And in fact, they don't even need to make sense. You do not have to be an artist. I certainly am not. However, as a freshman here at Missouri S&T many, many, many decades ago, I did take a mechanical drawing class, and I am still using a lot of those same tools and techniques today. I think everyone can sketch. It just takes use and practice. You know, you can explore a lot of ideas by sketching. You can use a pen, a pencil, a marker, a whiteboard marker, a piece of chalk, a crayon, really anything that feels right. The use of tracing paper as overlays is a fantastic way to capture your thoughts. I use sketching paper or tracing paper to overlay my initial thoughts. It helps me to see the various possibilities, and I don't throw any of these tracing papers away until the final design is actually produced. That you could ask my office, they're all over my office. You can also use different types of media for sketching. You can use paper, the tracing paper we talked about. You can use a whiteboard, a chalkboard, a piece of plywood, a new concrete slab or foundation wall, sand at the beach. You can use a digital tablet. And of course, my favorite is the cocktail napkin. My brother-in-law, John, recently completed phase one of their garden waterfall in their backyard. It's a gorgeous spot. There's water falling, there are frogs croaking at night. So I asked him, I said, John, how did this begin? How did you come up with these ideas? He showed me these simple sketches. Now, these simple sketches captured the essence of what he wanted to create. So he took these to the local landscaping supply company, and they immediately understood what he wanted to build. Sketching is thinking and communication. Sketching also brings to light certain aspects that were not previously considered. During the design of the waterfall, John began to realize the amount of soil and rock that he had to move. This was going to be a monumental project. Yes, and, as we heard earlier, is the one rule of improv, as well as one of the keys to effectively sketching. When you are improvisational, there is no need to have every step planned out. Sketching is similar in that it is unbounded and unscripted. It is thinking out loud on paper. You need to let your mind go untethered and not worrying about being correct. Sketching also brings and taps your intuition. Now, intuition, it's not magical. It is merely a faculty in which hunches are rapidly generated by the unconscious mind. Now, what software can do that? Sketching is a conduit to these unconscious thoughts in which the problem may have already have been solved. Many of these solutions will be off target. And in fact, most of them will, 90 to 95% will be off target. However, it is very important to the process. Just always sketch it again. I know it sounds counterintuitive, but sketching forces you to concentrate. Digital models are an important and an essential tool that we have. However, we should utilize all tools that we have available to us to cogitate, conceive, and create our designs. So how can you use sketching? First of all, sketching should be fun. Consider sketching as your daily playtime, or you don't have to worry and you can just relax and let your mind go wild. Technical doodling is a great way to capture your thoughts and to concentrate. Sketching also increases the amount of synapses in your neurotransmitters. It means it's good for your brain. That means that experiences are heightened and made more vivid and are easier to recollect. Sketching, you should be used to map out your daily tasks. Design that new playground, or to come up with a new garden, or a new workshop. Why don't you ideate to convert your 1980 Old Town Tripper into a canoe? I'm trying to, at least. So you need to be able to think out loud on paper. You will find that when you start to sketch, you will open a pathway to your brain to unleash your creativity. Thank you.